welcome you both in person and live stream. And we're glad that you're here and able to join us today. Our pastor, Dr. Tom Robbins, as most of you know, is recovering from extensive back surgery. And otherwise, he would have been here today. Sundays are pretty hard on his back these days. And he sends greetings to you and a very warm welcome. And now I want to introduce Mr. Wayne Backus, who is the dean of our American Guild of Organists chapter here in Central Texas. And Wayne will introduce our guest organist today. Again, welcome.
Thank you, Carl. You know, every time I walk into this room, I have memories of the most miraculous musical experiences through the years. I have to, anytime I have the opportunity, congratulate and thank the members of First United Methodist Church in Temple. They were the people who always did the oratorios, the great music of musical history, and brought musicians to this kind of pulpit, who so enriched our lives, both spiritual, musical, educational, and just living together as people who are sensitive to other people. One of those people who was brought here, I think, principally by the late Norlie Wendland, is Dr. Susan Ingrid Foray. I had the good fortune of being the music director at First Lutheran Church. I call it Our Lady of McDonald's. At that time, and having the privilege to work with, to party with, and most especially to learn from Susan Foray back in, shall I confess, the decade? The early 70s. And met through Susan so many giants of music in Texas. When we knew that Susan and her husband and favorite viola da gamba player, Dr. Charles Lang, were coming through, Carl and I met with them in Waco, and we went on a kind of a mini organ crawl and were able to bring Susan into this space to see this marvelous instrument, which was only a dream when she was here. There was a much smaller, maybe a third the size, old Pilcher pipe organ, but oh, it had such nice sounds on it. Some of us can still remember those beautiful sounds that it made and those musical experiences that it accompanied. Well, today we have a treat. A homecoming, one might say. If any of you were here and worshiping here in the early 70s, you will know and say amen to what I say is the glorious experience in music in this space at that time. Susan went on to North Texas, to Pacific Lutheran, to Perkins Seminary, to be the founder or co-founder of the Texas Baroque Ensemble, which was an artist group in residence at Round Top for many years and still functions in the Dallas area, playing early music, which is a specialty of hers. The thing that she has chosen to share with us today was a very important part of her life, having finished the master's degree at the Eastman School of Music in Rochester, New York. She was tapped with the Fulbright Scholar to study in Paris with the late Marcel Dupré and subsequently Jean Longlet, that genius blind organist for whom she was guide in America and who, besides being a dear friend, was a great mentor to Susan. Well, I could go on probably singing her praises or speaking her praises would be preferable, forever. But wearing my hat as dean of the Central Texas chapter of the American Guild of Organists, I must say we have seen a bit of a revival in the Central Texas chapter. And I want to remind you that the American Guild of Organists is not just for people who play the organ, but people who love the organ. And so I see our secretary, Jack Martin, seated right over here. And if you have an interest in learning about what we do in the Central Texas chapter or investigating membership, please see me or Jack at the conclusion of the concert. We would love to do more and more with the organ in the Waco and Temple Central Texas area. Well, I could go on forever, but I won't. Can I get an amen to that? And just tell you how thrilled I am to be able to introduce to you again and to welcome back to what I think she will always consider one of her homes, Dr. Susan Ingrid Foray.
Thank you, Wayne and Carl. What a wonderful homecoming. My goodness, they have really not only invited us, but feted us the whole couple of days we've been here getting to know the organ, the new organ. Well, new since I left here in the 70s. It's probably old for you. What isn't completely new are the spectacular windows, which I remember were designed by my good friend Judy Ofke from TCU. She was a very close friend of mine, and to see these windows really inspired this program of music that I learned 50 years ago when I was on my Fulbright in France and guiding Langlais around and so forth. The program notes have a lot of personal story in them, so I hope they're not too small that you can't actually read them as I play, because I'm not going to talk about all the pieces as I play them. First, to be here, I have to thank the Dr. Carl Bradley and the staff here of the church. It was wonderful to hear the Reverend Dr. Tom Rollins this morning, and to be here with the congregation. It's so welcoming. And of course, Wayne Backus, my very, very old, dear friend from many years. And we've kept in touch all these years, which is great. We had a lot of musical adventures, I remember, in the early 70s. So this truly is a very special time, because I don't play concerts anymore. They asked, and I retired from concert playing about 5 years ago. So here we are. I also want to thank my husband, doctor. He's a doctor too, so if you have any ailments, he's the one who's kept me walking and talking and functioning all these years. And he's a splendid musician, as is our son too, so I'm very grateful to them for giving me the inspiration to keep going and keep playing. So also, we have a really dear friend with whom I studied at North Texas here. I'm not sure where he's sitting, but it's the Reverend Dr. Charles Brown, former head of the organ department at UNT in Denton, and has also been a pastor at a wonderful church in Corpus Christi. He's now retired and living in Austin, so not that far away, and he's going to be serving the Austin AGO chapter. And to underline what Wayne said, in New Hampshire, we have encouraged people to join the chapter who are not necessarily organists, but certainly pianists and other keyboard people who are interested in the actual mechanics of the organ. So our professional organization is worth joining if you have an interest in that. So I'll underline that. This program is a set of meditations and impressions of the life of Christ. As you can tell, it kind of goes through the life of Christ, starting with Langlais' treatment of Ave Maria, Ave Maris Stella. And I talk about the light that he saw in her being and in this piece. So that light he gave, which he couldn't see, he gave to his students and those who to whom he opened a certain amount of light, which we can not see, like these beautiful windows, but we can feel and experience. And certainly through this music, it opens that possibility to see the light. The second piece by Charles Tournemire, who was the predecessor at Sainte-Clotilde of Jean Langlais. Langlais was actually chosen by Tournemire to succeed him at this beautiful church, which had a gorgeous organ. I say had because it's been changed and pretty much destroyed now, but it was the organ of Franck, and then Tournemire for dozens and decades of years, and then Langlais for another 40 years. So all these pieces, when he toured the United States, he loved to play this music because he was very fond, as was Marcel Dupré, of this kind of organ, which made it easier to set pistons and have the electronics so that everything was easy to manage and easier to play. It doesn't make the piece easier to play, but it's the kind of organ, and the sounds of this organ are very well matched with the pieces from the 1930s through the 40s and the 50s, which are on this program. So the second piece, I'm not going to play all five movements. Tournemire wanted his music to be played only in a religious setting and not for personal gain. And I had promised that I would adhere to that. So that's the context of this program, is that it is devotional, it's meditative, and I'd ask you to withhold applause until the very end of the program. It begins quietly and it ends quietly. And Tournemire would have approved of that, I hope. He wrote five pieces for each of the Sundays of the church year, which are very famous now, the mystical organ. And this is the one from Epiphany. So after the birth of Christ, with the Langlais piece, we'll celebrate Epiphany through these last two movements of the Epiphany suite, and then on to Lent with Jesus falling from the weight of the cross, and then the two words, the two of the seven last words, again by Tournemire, which I was not allowed to play in concert, but I was given the story of how I got to hear those pieces is on your program notes here. And then the final Easter piece, which is of this season, Death and Resurrection. And then another peaceful piece to respond to the turmoil and the troubles that we have in our world today, and to end us all on a contemplative, peaceful message of hope and peace.